I am S.B. Mishra, who is going to teach you real number, chapter 1 of class 10 mathematics. Observation. You know that when 35 is divided by 5, remainder is 0. When 36 divided by 5, remainder is 1. 37 remainder 2, 38 remainder 3, 39 remainder 4, and 40 remainder 0. If divisor is 5, remainder is never more than 5. Remainder is either 0 or 1 or 2 or 3 or 4. So remember it. Now take A by B. A by B is a rational number. Start division of A by B. Quotient and remainder is not known. Not known to you. So let Q stands for quotient and R stands for remainder. R stands for remainder. Now let us divide A by B, Q for quotient, R for remainder. Since we know that dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder, so A is equal to A dividend, A is equal to BQ plus R, where R is equal to 0. R is more than 0, all 1, 2, 3, 4 are more than 0, and R is less than B, R is less than 5, so R is less than B. Either remember this format, or in shortcut you can compose all these three equations, or this is equal to this, A is equal to BQ plus R. This is called Euclid division lemma. Now problem number 1, what is Euclid division lemma? Answer is A is equal to BQ plus R, where R is equal to 0, R is more than 0, R is less than B. Or your answer may be written in this form, A is equal to BQ plus R, where R is equal to, R is less than equal to, sorry, where 0 is less than equal to R, and R is less than equal to B. Choose any one of the, know this formula permanently. This A is equal to BQ plus R will be helpful to you in answering many questions. So remember it. Now problem number 1. Use Euclid division lemma to find the HCF of 272 and 1032. You know that the small number will divide the larger number in 3 times. The remainder is 216. Now 216 is smaller than 272. Then 216 will divide 272. Then remainder is 56, which is smaller than 216. Again 56 will divide 216, remainder is 48, smaller than 46. Again remainder is 8, which will divide 48, remainder is 0. After that use Euclid division lemma for this. 1032, dividend, divisor into quotient plus remainder. Again for this, divisor into quotient plus remainder. Again for this, 216. Again for 56, again for this 48. Now the last divisor, 8, which make the remainder 0, is called HCF. Now also find the LCM of this and this. So remember a very important formula. This is true, strictly true for two numbers. HCF into LCM is equal to first number into second number. This should be remembered, formula must be remembered to you. This implies 8 into LCM, since HCF 8 is known to us, 8 into LCM is equal to 272 into 1032. So LCM is equal to, 8 will go to the denominator, 34 into 1032, so 35088. Now problem number 2. Problem number 2. So that the positive even integers are always in the form 2q and odd integers are always in the form 2q plus 1. So remember it carefully that our requirement is 2. And in Euclid division lemma, which is known to you, know, remember it permanently that A is equal to BQ plus R. In A is equal to BQ plus R, since 2 is requirement, so put immediately B is equal to 2 and get A is equal to 2Q plus R. Why B is taken as 2? Because in the question, 2 is the need. So A is equal to 2Q plus R. Earlier you have seen that B is equal to 5, then remainders are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, never 5 or more. So here the remainder will be 0 and 1. Now put r is equal to 0, a is equal to 2q plus 0. 2q is even, you know this is proved, because multiple of 2 is even. Now r is equal to 1, then a is equal to 2q plus 1. 2q plus 1 is odd because even plus odd is odd. Third problem, so that every odd positive integer is in the form 4q plus 1, 4q plus 3. Again the known formula, a is equal to bq plus r. Since 4 is requirement, so we put b is equal to 4. Put b is equal to 4 as needed. We select b as per need. If b is 4, then r will be 0, 1, 2, 3. So write a is equal to bq plus r. B selected as 4, so 4q plus r, r 0, 1, 2, 3. Put r is equal to 1, this is equation 1. In equation 1, putting r is equal to 0, 4q plus 0 is 4q again. Put r is equal to 1, 4q plus 1, this is odd because even plus odd is odd. R is equal to 2, a is equal to 4q plus 2. Not required, this will be even because even plus even is even, but this is not required. First is also not required. Our requirement is proved. Again, if r is equal to 3, a is equal to 4q plus 3, odd, proved. Reason, multiple of 4 is even and even plus odd is odd. Now come to the problem number 4. So that every odd positive integer is in the form 6q plus 1, 6q plus 3, 6q plus 5, as above. Again, known formula remembered by you, a is equal to bq plus r. So put b is equal to 6, put b is equal to 6. Then a is equal to 6q plus r, 6q, where r is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You already know that when b is 6, r will be 0 to 5. Now put in this equation number 1, put r 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as above. If 0, 6q, if 1, 6q plus 1, odd, proved. 6q plus 1 is the requirement, proved. If r is equal to 3, 6q plus 3, odd, proved. If r is equal to 5, 6q plus 5, odd, proved. These three are not required. If required, you can write here. Or if in the question, prove that 6q is even, 6q plus 2 is even, 6q plus 4 is even, you can give the reason. The multiple of 6 is even, even plus even is even, even plus even is even. But this is not required. Now come to the another problem. This is very sensitive problem. 5, so that the square of any positive integer is in the form 3m, 3m plus 1. Again, we need 3. So, known formula, a is equal to bq plus r. Put b is equal to 3, then remainder will be 0, 1, 2. Now, a is equal to 3q plus r, but we need a square of numbers. So, as requirement, a squaring is necessary. So, squaring both sides, we get a square is equal to a plus b ka whole square. You can use a plus b ka whole square formula. A square plus 2 into a into b plus b square. This becomes this. So we are getting a square is equal to 9q square plus 6q plus r square, where r is equal to 0, 1, 2. Now putting r is equal to 0 in this formula, a square is equal to 9q square plus 0 plus 0. Take 3 common. Then inside the bracket 3q square, so whatever inside the bracket is called m. So 3m from proved. Put r is equal to 1 in first equation, a square is equal to again this. So from first 2, take 3 common, then 1 is left. So whatever inside the bracket, we consider it as m. Never think that this m is smaller, this m is larger. This is of simply form. Inside the term, whatever there may be, this is called m. So 3m plus 1 form. Again, put r is equal to 2, we get this. But 4 is not required, so 4 is broken in two parts, 3 plus 1. Now from 3 terms, take 3 common, then plus 1. So whatever inside the bracket, this will be taken as m. So 3m plus 1 proved. Okay, good luck. Go through this study material and always keep in contact with me.